Hello YouTube fam, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name's Tina and I make videos on lifestyle, home, and DIY projects every single week. And today's video is a really exciting one because I'm finally working on my living room makeover. I've been in this apartment for quite a while now and it was finally time to get to it. And I'm really excited to show you guys how it turned out because I absolutely love it. And I hope that this makeover inspires you guys to transform one of your spaces, especially with the holidays coming up. I think it's important to have a really cozy and homey space. Also, I want to give a huge shout out to Fi, who is the sponsor of today's video. I got some really awesome pieces for the living room and I can't wait to show you guys. All right, so without further ado, let's jump into day one for some before shots. All right, so welcome to my living room. This is basically the only thing that is here right now. So this is a Calyx unit from IKEA and this is actually supposed to go in our entryway, but since it was one of the first items that we bought for our place, we just put it here and then put our TV right on top, and that's where it's just stayed for the past couple of weeks. So as you can probably tell, this has just become a catch-all for all of our stuff. I just have a bunch of DIY things, decor, electronics, PS4 that we definitely are going to hide in the reveal shots later. So although I love this piece, this is definitely not something that I want to keep in the living room. And if we pan over here, we basically have a hole that literally just happened today. So I used one of those sticky hooks and it wasn't by command. It was a very cheap one from Dollar Tree. And I ruined my wall. I would definitely not recommend those. Especially on a painted wall like this, you could probably get away with it if you were using it on a different surface. So I'm gonna have to spackle this and get the paint matched to this, so that should be fun. And then here I have my little plant shelf. I got this also from IKEA and it was 25 bucks. It is such a great little plant stand. Originally I bought this for our balcony, but it works so well in this corner that I might just keep it here, but we shall see. Excuse this terrible backlighting, but we have two windows here. So, oh, this is a lot better. So we have a giant window to the left and then our door on the right hand side. And this goes out to our balcony and this gets so much light, especially in the evening. I love it so much, but we definitely need to put some curtains up here. And then if we pan over to the left, you guys are probably familiar with this. This is our sliding wall, which basically is a wall of sliding doors. And I kind of have a love-hate relationship with this wall because although it definitely opens up our bedroom and makes the apartment feel a little bit bigger, it kind of is tricky to maneuver all the different doors. So figuring out the whole layout of the living room is going to be a little bit trickier, but I do have a plan and I hope that it works well. And then lastly, we have a pile of junk on the floor, which usually happens when you don't have a lot of furniture. And next to the pile of stuff is actually where our kitchen and our dining nook is. And I don't really want to show it to you guys because it is a big mess right now. So instead, let's just clean everything up and start off with a fresh, clean canvas. Hello from VoiceOver Tina. So you guys already know the drill. I always start off a makeover by cleaning everything. And even if you're like me and you're not painting any walls, I think that clearing out a space completely allows you to reimagine it and just start off fresh. And as a quick backstory on me, in my previous place, I had a mix of hand-me-down furniture and a couple of new pieces that I bought. And even though I put my own decor style to it, it truly never felt like my own. So I'm just so happy to have this new blank apartment. It really allows me to be more intentional of what I bring. And I truly had so much fun designing it. This makeover was exactly what I needed to make this apartment feel more like home. So now it's nice and empty and also very echoey in this room. I think the next thing I'm gonna do is put down my TV console and then maybe my couch, just because I have a layout in mind, but I don't know if it's going to be the best configuration of this since it is such a small space. And I think for reference, I'm actually gonna measure this space so I can show you exactly how small this room is and what we're working with.
Wow, okay.
So of course, before I actually bought everything, I measured out this room, but I kind of forgot, so I just wanted to measure it one more time just to make sure. But this room is 10 feet, 5 inches by 11 feet. I just went into Google and typed in average apartment living room size, and it says that a living room that measures 12 by 18 feet is a fairly small one. So this living room is definitely on the small side, but that doesn't mean that it can't be stylish. So first things first, let's build out my TV console.
Crap, can I even move this? It's so heavy.
No. Oh, okay.
Okay, so this TV stand was a little bit of a struggle for us to put together. I mentioned in my bedroom makeover that Brian and I really love to put together furniture, but this piece was a challenge because of how many pieces there were. I chose a mid-century modern style TV console with plenty of storage, and it's in this beautiful warm wood finish. You'll notice that I'm adding in a lot of natural tones to the space because of how cool toned everything else is. My goal is to make our home as cozy as possible, so I'm going to have a lot of wood, gold, and warm tone accents throughout the design.
Ooh. That hyperlapse probably made that look so much faster, but this actually took a couple hours for us to build, and it's finally up, and I'm really liking the way that it looks. So the last thing I'm gonna do today is to put in our couch. So we ended up going to Living Spaces, and I felt like I was on Mr. Kate because she has her competition show there. They have some really awesome pieces, and they actually have a whole collection of items that are perfect for smaller spaces like I have. Definitely check them out. The piece that I ended up choosing is a sectional, which fits perfectly against this back wall of sliding doors. So let's go ahead and fill up this space.
So if I'm being completely honest, this couch actually was not our first choice, but we just had to work with our budget and our space. And we really wanted an L-shaped sectional couch, and this one has an interchangeable chaise and it fits perfectly in this space. So it was going to be the best choice for us. I think this light gray color actually works well with pulling in all the gray kitchen cabinets that we have. And I think a lot of you guys are probably in the same boat because gray is such a safe couch color. But that doesn't mean that you can't have fun with it. There are so many ways that you can totally dress up your couch. You can add some throw pillows, blankets, or even change out the legs to give it a completely new look. Styling this couch is going to be a fun challenge, and I'm just so excited to style it and bring it all together.
Alright, so the couch is looking so good. I'm excited to have one back in my life because honestly, we were sitting on our bed just watching the TV through the sliding doors. So for right now, we're just gonna keep this layout as it is. The nice thing about this couch is that it has a reversible chaise, so you can put this on either the left side or the right side. And that's really awesome to change it depending on what you need it for. So it's now almost 9 p.m., so I will see you guys in the morning. Good night! So I just got off of work and it is now the next day. So my goal today is to get out my gallery wall as well as put down my rug. And I think that's really going to tie everything together. Especially right now, it's looking very gray with my gray couch. And I'm trying to introduce some warm tones, so that's really going to help. So like I mentioned in my intro, this video is sponsored by Phi, and I'm really happy to be partnering up with them again. Last time I partnered up with them on my kitchen makeover, and I just absolutely love the pieces that I picked out. So I have everything laid out on my couch, and first we have this really fun abstract art piece. I really love all the different color tones in here. I also like that they include a little bit of cool tones and then as well as some black details. So that's really gonna help tie everything together. So what's great about Phi is that you can buy the print by itself in many different sizes, but you can also buy it framed. So I do have two pieces that I picked out. I just had to get this print when I saw it because I really wanted to pay homage to Chicago in my gallery wall. I just wanted to have a little piece of home into it, and I really love the colors of this. It's a very minimal and then has a nice little pop of blue, and I think that kind of ties really nicely with that green over here. So these two are just gonna look perfectly next to each other. I think this would also make such a great gift because they have so many different city-related prints. And then the other print that I got is this really big one. It is super simple, and I've actually seen it on Instagram before, and I loved it. I got this in a little bit of a larger size just because I wanted it to be my focal print. And it is a very, very light pink. I don't know if you guys can tell in this lighting. It's so gloomy today. Yeah, super simple, but super cute. I also really love the quality of the frames. I got them all in this beautiful oak finish, and I think it's going to look perfect in this space. And aside from these prints, I actually picked up this really cute plant hanger. I really want to add it to the gallery wall. So this is just a fun little way to do it. And then I also picked up these super cute pillows. They have such a great selection. And I actually picked up this yellow one because I've been seeing so many knotted pillows on Instagram. And I thought it would be perfect for this couch just to give it a little bit of contrast. You can already see how much it's just warming up the gray couch. And then I also got this pillow cover, and it is just so beautiful. Beautiful. I love how much texture is in this pillow, and it is just so beautifully woven. I am obsessed with it.
I'm really happy with all my pieces, and as you guys can tell, Phi has some really amazing selections for your whole home. They have everything from prints to furniture to rugs and even lighting, so there definitely is something there for everyone. And I also really love that you're able to support emerging artists on their site, so there are so many cool and unique pieces on there. So if you're interested in checking them out, you can click on my exclusive code down below to get 20% off your entire order. The code is valid 72 hours after you first click it, and I'll be sure to link all the items that I picked out down below. All right, as you guys can tell, it's already getting dark outside. I'm really upset that it gets dark by like 5 o'clock now because of daylight savings, but I will just turn on the lights and get started on the gallery wall. Whenever I'm planning out a gallery wall, I just like to lay it down on the floor first, and that way I can really just play around with all of the different placement options. This can get a little overwhelming, so I would suggest to take a picture of every layout that you come up with and then choose your final one. So to put together this gallery wall, I'm using these gold picture hangers. You can just stick these right into the wall and it'll create a tiny hole, but it's going to be really easy to fill and paint when you move out. So I would really recommend these ones, especially if you have a lot of frames going up. And since this gallery wall only has 3 frames, I'm opting to forego the whole craft paper template hack, and I'm just gonna start by hanging up my middle frame first. And if you caught my kitchen makeover, you probably already know this tip, but this is my hack for hanging up frames by yourself. To see exactly where you want things to be placed, film yourself holding the frame at different heights and ensure that you like the placement. So that's exactly what I'm doing here with all the frames. And from there, I'm just gonna mark off in pencil where I want my picture hanger to be, and I just pushed that right in. It was actually a lot easier than I thought it would be, and I think these just look so much better than just hammering in a nail. So after I got the middle one up, I'm just going to go ahead and hang up the remaining 2 frames and make sure that they are evenly spaced out. And after I hung up all the frames, I'm going to go ahead and add my non-frame pieces to the gallery wall. I love mixing up my gallery wall, so this is just a perfect way to switch out a few pieces when you want a different vibe. So I'm really happy with how the gallery wall is looking. I'm just gonna keep it a little bit more on the minimal side because I'm sure that I'm going to want to change it around and add more prints and frames. So this gives me enough room to grow into it. So next up, I'm going to put in my rug, and I'm a little bit nervous. I feel like I say this every time I put in a rug, but I literally spent hours online looking for the perfect rug for this space. And I'm always just a little bit more anxious when I order things online because I have no idea if the colors are gonna be true to what they say in the pictures. So I'm gonna cross my fingers and hope that it comes out as I imagined it to be.
When choosing a rug, I always keep in mind the sizing. A lot of times, smaller rugs will actually make your space look a lot smaller. And since this living room is already pretty tiny, I made sure that this rug was larger than my couch so that it would fill up the space and make it look a lot larger.
You're not supposed to stand on that.
This hurts.
It's a rug pad.
Why do you have pad?
So it doesn't slip. So I'm gonna have to cut the rug pad, which is totally part of the directions, so if it doesn't fit completely, you can just snip off one end.
I'm stoked for this new rug because I honestly have never used a colorful rug like this before. I've always loved the look of vintage red rugs, and this one has a similar vibe with some neutral tones woven throughout, and I think it's going to be perfect to tie in all the tones in our home.
Alright, crisis averted. I forgot that the rug actually has some variations in the color. So one side is a little bit lighter than the other side, so I ended up putting that over to the corner where the couch is covering it most. So that way we have more of that deeper, rusty, orangey red color showing, and that's really what I wanted, so then I could tie this in and make it a lot warmer. And already this is making the space feel so much more inviting. So next I'm gonna build out the coffee table, and then tomorrow I will style everything and finish up the room. Good morning, guys. Welcome to the third and final day of this makeover. I feel like I always take a couple of days to work on my makeovers because I do work during the week, but I absolutely love every single moment of it. I'm sure a lot of you guys out there can relate, especially if you work as well during the week and just have to find time in the evenings or the weekends to work on your passion projects. And it's definitely been super rewarding for me, so I'm just so happy to wrap it up today. As you guys saw, I worked on the coffee table last night, and I'm about to put the final touch to it. It is a lift top coffee table, which is really awesome because it has so much storage in it, and as the name suggests, you can lift the top layer of it up, and that way you can eat and work on it. You don't have to hunch down to the height of the table, which is just a lot more comfortable, and I love the versatility of it.
All right, so now that we have all of our big furniture pieces in, it's time to put in the small finishing touches. My to-do list for today includes putting up curtains, building a lamp, adding in a bunch of plants, and then putting in the finishing touches with all of our decor pieces, and then I can reveal the final space to you guys. So if you watched my last makeover in my bedroom, you will be familiar with this hack. But these command hooks hold up to 7.5 pounds each, so make sure that your curtain rod isn't too heavy. And the one that I'm using is nothing fancy. I didn't want to draw a lot of attention to it since I'm using these command hooks. And these curtains are definitely going to soften up the harsh lines of the window. They're sheer, so they're gonna let in a nice amount of light while adding privacy. And because of the balcony door and the sliding doors, I wasn't able to extend the rod past the window, but I just made it work. I'm loving how these curtains look. They just draw your eye upwards and really soften up and give the room a nice cozy look. The curtains are already making such a big difference. I really love this light coming in. Like, how beautiful does it look right now? It's getting so sunny today, which makes me so happy because it's been very gloomy lately. Overall, I'm super happy with how this is looking and it just looks so magical. So since the living room is a very open concept and opens right into our kitchen, I'm going to add a light to kind of just stop your eye and kind of just designate this area as the living room. The rug on the floor already does a really good job at that, but I wanted something with a little bit more height. So here's the light I bought. It's from Target. It has a really cool mid-century modern vibe to it. I love that it has the brass tones, which we're also trying to really tie in with the rest of the room, and it's just perfect. Okay. The last thing I need to do is to put in all of my plants. As you guys know, I have these huge windows here, so a lot of my plants are going to be in this main living area, and all that's left is the decor pieces, and the room will be complete. I absolutely love styling my place with plants. It gives the room so much life and honestly just makes me so happy to look at them. It brings the outdoors inside and adds in a beautiful pop of color. Our living room gets quite a bit of light, so I'm able to sprinkle these plants throughout the room and really fill up the space. All right, so it's time to style up this couch. As I mentioned, I think that gray couches are super common, but that doesn't mean that it has to be boring. So I'm gonna get rid of the pillows that it comes with and add in a bit of texture and color. I love that these colors really play off of the tones in the rugs and really ties the whole living room together. So as you guys may or may not know, I have a love-hate relationship with these sliding doors. While it's great for opening up the space, it's really tricky to style. So while I would love to put some wallpaper on it, it just lets in so much light into our bedroom and I definitely don't want to lose that. So instead, I'm just going to hang a decorative piece above the couch so that it looks a little bit more like a wall instead of a sliding door. The room is finally finished, but before I reveal it to you guys, let's take a look back at what it looked like before. Not very functional, very empty, not a lot was going on. And I'm so proud of how this living room came out, so take a look at the after. Thank you. What do you guys think of my living room? Let me know in the comments down below. I'm really happy with how it looks. It's just so much more cozy and just really feels like a home. And I hope that this inspires you guys and shows you that even if you have a small space, you can make it super stylish and very homey. And I'm just so in love with how it came out. I'm excited to have movie nights in here and just grow into this space as we continue to settle in. And again, a huge thank you to Five for sponsoring today's video. If you're interested in checking them out, make sure that you use my link down below to get 25% off. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe down below for new videos every single week. And thank you guys all so much for watching. Stay inspired and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!